In this lecture, we want to talk about discrete random variables. Now, in this class, we've talked about the word discrete before. It's used to describe a quantitative variable that has a finite number of outcomes or a countable number of outcomes. The word random, we've talked about random outcomes in probability before. And in mathematics, when you hear the term variable or the word variable, you often think of like an unknown value that gets denoted with the letter x. So we want to put all that together and talk about discrete random variables as it relates to our course statistics. So our objectives that we're going to get through in this lecture here, we're going to distinguish between discrete and continuous random variables. So we'll talk about both types. We're going to identify discrete probability distributions. And then finally, what we're going to do is we're going to construct probability histograms. Okay, so let's start with the first objective here, distinguish between discrete and continuous random variables. So first off, a random variable is a numerical measure of an outcome from a probability experiment. So its value is determined by chance. Okay, random variables are denoted using letters such as X. Okay, so the important thing here is a random variable, this word variable that we see. Okay, so remember in mathematics, we think of a variable as an unknown value. Well, in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to tie this unknown value, all right, as a numerical measure, the outcome of a probability experiment. So this unknown value is determined by a probability experiment. Now, if you remember what a probability experiment means, what it is, it has uncertain results. And is repeatable. So what is a probability experiment that has uncertain result, it's repeatable, and its outcome is a numerical measure? Well, you know, something like a die roll, right? That'll actually be something we talk about in a little bit here. When I roll a die, I don't know exactly what I'm going to get, but so that's the uncertain results, and it's absolutely repeatable. Okay, so you can just keep rolling the die. So how we're going to use this concept of a random variable is we're going to do something like this. We're going to say we're going to let the random variable x be equal to the result on a die roll. Okay, and that's how we're going to use this x notation here of this in the concept of a variable. So a discrete random variable, kind of like a die roll, okay, has either a finite or countable number of values. So like if you look at this discrete random variable x here, this random variable x, it has a finite number of outcomes, right? Like when you roll a six-sided die, you can only get the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. Okay, so the values of a discrete random variable can be plotted on a number line, like with spaces between each point. So like for the die roll. You know, if you draw a number line, you know, here's 1, here's 2, here's 3, here's 4, here's 5, and here's 6. It makes sense that way, okay? This section will primarily be talking about or studying discrete random variables. So when we get to, when we get out of discrete random variables, we'll move right into continuous random variables. So these have an infinite, this or discrete random variables have infinitely many values. So the values of a continuous random variable can be plotted on a line in uninterrupted fashion. So if you remember the term continuous, we generally refer to this as measurements of some type. Okay, so some examples of discrete random variables are things like heights of individuals, you know, time it takes an adult to run a mile, you know, things like that tend to be continuous variables. So we'll study continuous random variables in a lot more detail in the following section of the course. Okay, so let's just distinguish now between discrete and continuous random variables. So we have three examples here. Let's determine whether the following random variables are discrete or continuous, and let's just state the possible values for the random variables. Okay, so the first one, A here. The number of light bulbs that burn out in a room of 10 light bulbs in the next year. Okay, so this room has 10 light bulbs. So what we want to do is we want to count. Okay, so listen how I said it. Count the number of light bulbs that burn out in the next year. Well, that is a discrete random variable because there's a finite number of bulbs that can burn out. So the possible values are 0 bulbs could burn out, 1, 2, comma, all the way to 10 bulbs could burn out. The number of leaves on a randomly selected oak tree. So we're counting the leaves on the randomly selected oak tree. So this again is discrete, right? Like it can have 0 leaves, it could have 1 leaf, it could have 2 leaf, it could have 1,000 leaves, okay? But it's countable. Now this next one, the length of time between calls to 911, say to the local dispatch station. So the length of time is a measurement of some type. So it's continuous, and time is just greater than 0 here in this case. All right, so we're going to be dealing in this section with these types here. Okay, and this right here is covered in our next section of the class. All right, so now let's talk about how you identify discrete probability distributions. So this is a new concept here for our class, a probability distribution or probability distributions. We're going to be talking about this a lot. Over the next coming lectures. So what exactly is a probability distribution, at least here, how it relates to a discrete random variable? So a probability distribution, just in general, provides the possible values of the random variable x and their corresponding probabilities. Okay, so we're going to have the random variable. X, and then we're also going to have their corresponding probabilities. All right, which we're going to denote as P of X. Okay, so a probability distribution can be in the form of a table. That's what we're going to study a lot in this section. A graph, we'll touch briefly on a graph at the end of this section, but when we get to talking about continuous random variables, we'll use graphs quite a bit. Or you can even use a mathematical formula to describe the probability distribution. Okay, so but for this lecture, this section here, this video, probability distributions provide the possible values of the random variable x right here and their corresponding probabilities. As soon as you see the first example of this, I think it'll make a lot more sense. Okay, so just some rules for a discrete probability distribution that we always need to follow. So, as I said in the previous slide, we're going to let P of x denote the probability that the random variable x is equal to some value. Okay, so you'll see me write things like this. Like suppose let x equal to the result on a die roll. If I write something like this, what's the probability of a 5? You know, you roll a 5 on a 6-sided die. Well, that's obviously just 1 out of 6. All right, the two rules that you need to follow is the sum of all the corresponding probabilities has to sum to 1, and the individual probabilities here need to be between 0 and 1 inclusive, meaning you can't have any negative probabilities, and obviously you can't have a probability greater than 1. Okay, so here's the first example of a probability distribution. So the table to the right shows the probability distribution of the random variable x, where x represents the results on a die roll. So the probability distribution lists the possible values of the random variable. Right, so when you roll a 6-sided die, you can get a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, a 5, or a 6, obviously, and their corresponding probabilities, okay, in this column right here. So like for example, the probability you roll a 1 is 1/6, the probability you roll a 2 is 1/6, probability roll a 3 is 1/6, probability roll a 4 is 1/6, and so on. So it's just all the possible values in a nice neat table with their corresponding probabilities right next to it. You know, you can go on and have probability distributions for, say, something that looks like this. Okay, this table here to the right shows the probability distribution of the random variable x, where x represents the number of movies streamed on Netflix each month by households with children under 1 year of age. So, at the time of recording this video, I have a child under 1 year of age, and I don't get to stream many videos or many movies anymore on Netflix like I did when my wife and I didn't have our child. So, you know, what this probability distribution says is okay, the possible values of x are 0 movies a month, 1 movie a month, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Obviously, there's probably more in the real world households that stream more than 5 movies a month if they have a child under 1 year of age, but we're just gonna cut it off here. And over here, you're gonna see it's their corresponding probabilities. So the probability that a household streams 0 movies a month is 0.16. Probability they stream 1 movie a month is 0.58, and so on and so on. Okay. Let's ask this, okay? Let me give you some and just let's just say, is this a probability distribution? So you look here, you look at the values of x and you look at their corresponding probabilities. And to check if it's a probability distribution, what you have to do is you have to see if the probabilities sum up to 1. And if you sum up all these corresponding probabilities, they don't sum up to 1. So this is not a probability distribution. All right, looking at this one here. Is this a probability distribution? Well, this should be a red flag right here. Okay, can you have negative probabilities? No. So, you know, whenever you see a negative probability like this, obviously there's some type of error. How about this one? If we change it to 0.04, you know, if you sum up these probabilities, as long as the sum of the probabilities sum to 1, you're good. You're good. All right, so notice in these examples, like we've chosen x to go, you know, 0 to 5 in order, even with the die roll example of, you know, 1 through 6 in order. So let me ask you this question. Is this a probability distribution? Okay, where the possible values of x are negative 10, 0, and 10. Okay, notice how they're not in order, but their corresponding probabilities are 0.25, 0.50, and 0.25. Well, yes, this is a probability distribution. So the reason is the corresponding probabilities all sum to 1. So this is good. This is good. The x's here, you know, the you can go negative 10, 0, 10. It does not always need to be things like 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, the x values can have spaces between them, you know, as long as the probability distributions, the corresponding probabilities sum to 1. That's all that really matters here. All right, let's finally talk about constructing what we call probability histograms. So a probability histogram is just a histogram in which the horizontal axis corresponds to the value of the random variable, and the vertical axis represents the probability of that value on the random variable. So a histogram, what this means is the horizontal axis is going to get the corresponding value of the random variable x, and the vertical axis gets the probability of those random variables x. And remember, a histogram has no spaces between the values on the horizontal axis. Right, like a bar chart, we had spaces between the values, but here whenever you see a histogram, there's going to be no spaces between the bars of the graph. So let's go back and let's do this Netflix example. So let's draw a probability histogram of the probability distribution that we see on the right, okay, which represents the number of movies streamed on Netflix each month, as I said, for households with a child under 1 year of age. So I'm going to just show here in Excel how this was done. So along the horizontal axis, you got the possible values of the random variable x. Okay. And along the vertical axis, you got the corresponding probabilities, p of x. You know, like the first one, 0.6. So for the value of 0, you go up to 0.6. For the value of 1, it was 0.58. So you would build the bar right off it and go up to 0.58. The next one, for random variable value of 2, it was 0.22. So you would go up to 0.22 and draw the bar. Then the next one for a value of 3, it was 0.10. So you'd go to 0.10 here and get it right there. Then for 4, it was 0.3. And then for 5, it was 0.1. All right, class, I hope this quick introduction here to discrete random variables, probability distributions, and probability histograms was helpful.